I am Santosh Gayankar. I am solving the problem of mechanics of material. In that one, indeterminate structure, both ends are fixed here. A bar of 800 mm length is attached rigidly at A and B. A and B, it is rigidly attached as shown in the figure. The forces of 30 kN, 60 kN act as shown on the bar, where Young's modulus E is equal to 200 GPa. The E is given here, 200 GPa. We have to convert into 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. Determine the reactions at both the end. We have to find out the reaction at both the end. If the bar diameter is 25 mm, diameter is given, D is equal to 25 mm here. 25. Find the stresses at each and change in length of each portion. We have to find out the stresses and delta L, change in length. Now we are assuming here, first I will assume it, assume first part, this part I will assume it as tensile P1, next part I will assume it as tensile P1, next third part I will assume it as positive, again P3. Now, with the help of this one, I will create an equation. That means this become positive, positive, negative, and negative. Now, this is positive. It becomes P1 minus P2. This is minus this direction is equal to 30 kN positive. Equation 1. Second, this type, this become second equation. P2 is positive, P3 is negative, is equal to 60 kN, equation 2. With the diagram, we know that delta L is equal to 0. Therefore, it can written as delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 is equal to 0. Now, delta L1 is nothing but P1 L1 divided by AE plus P2 L2 divided by AE plus P3 L3. Divided by AE is equal to 0. Because area and Young's modulus are same, this becomes 0. Let us move this side, it becomes 0. Therefore, it can be written as what P1 into L1, L1 is nothing but this is L1, this is L2, this is L3. 275 plus P2 into 150 plus P3 into 375 is equal to 0. Equation 3. There are 3 equations here. First equation is P1 minus P2 is equal to 30 kN. P2 minus P3 is equal to 60 kN. Now here the direction of 60 is minus here. Arrow of minus is minus here. Right? Minus. Minus 60 here. Not the positive. Minus 60. Now minus 60. And about this one? P1 is equal to 275. Plus P2 is equal to 150 plus P3 is equal to 375 is equal to 0. With the help of the calculator, calculate here values you have to calculate. Calculate the values with the help of calculator. Shift 5 2, first is 1. Minus 1, third is 0, P3 is 0, there is no P3 here, 30, next P1 is not there, 0, 1, minus 1 and minus 60, here 275, 150, 375, 0, first answer is P1 is equal to minus 8.4375 kN. This minus indicate the first assumption, whatever we have made at the start of the problem is wrong. We have to reverse that direction. Now second is P2 minus 38.4375 kN. Second also we have to reverse the direction. What about third? Third is 21. The third assumption is correct here because it is a positive, it is a tensile. P3 is equal to 21.5625 kilonewton. Redraw the diagram. We are going to redraw the diagram. We are going to redraw the diagram. First is compressive because value is 8. 8 point, 8 point, the minus indicate only direction change, 8.4375 kilonewton. That means shortening occurs here. 8.4378 kilonewton compression. Second is again compression, 38.4375 kilonewton, 38.4375 kilonewton. Again it is compressive. Third is tensile. Third is tensile, that is 21.5625 kilonewton. 21.5625 kilonewton. It is positive. Tensile. Tensile. Now we have to find out the stresses in each portion. Stresses in each portion. Each portion. The first section, sigma 1 is equal to P1A. What is P1? 8.4375 into 10 raised to 3. Area is pi by 4 into diameter they have given is 25 square. The answer is 17.173 Newton per mm square. It is compressive. Sigma 2 for section 2, P2 divided by A. What is P2? P2 is nothing but 38.4375 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi by 4 into 25 square. The answer is 78.3042 Newton per mm square. Compressive. Similarly, sigma 3 is equal to P3 divided by A is nothing but 21.5625 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi by 4 into 25 square. Answer is 43.926 Newton per mm square. It is tensile. Apart from this one, we have to find out the stresses for each portion. Now, first one I will consider elongation in each portion. First, I will consider the elongation delta AB is nothing but P1 L1 divided by AE. What is P1? 8.4375 into 10 raised to 3 into L1 is L1 value 275. This is the L1 value 275 divided by what is area? Pi by 4 into 25 square into Young's modulus 200 into 10 raised to 3. The answer is 0.02363 mm. Similarly, for delta CD P2 L2 divided by AE. What is P2? 38.4375 into 10 raised to 3 into 150 is the length, 150 divided by pi by 4 into 25 square is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3. Answer is 0.05873 mm. This is compressive. Last will be tensile. Delta L dB is nothing but P3 L3 divided by AE. What is P3? P3 is nothing but 21.5625 into 10 raised to 3 into length is 375 into 375 divided by pi by 4 into 25 square. Diameter is given 200 into 10 raised to 3. Answer is 0.08236 mm. It is tensile. In this way, you have to solve the problem of the indeterminate structure. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.